my name is Valentina Prado. I am from Cali, Colombia, and I am a senior in civil engineering.
Hey, my name is Nathan Abai Cabela. I'm from Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. I'm a graduating senior, and I'm a civil engineering teacher.
Well, I was looking for a tennis scholarship. I wanted to play tennis in college, and I also wanted to study engineering. So it was hard to find a school that would give tennis scholarships and that had engineering and that it had accreditation.
I'm Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, and I came to the Pinewood School down on 49, not so far from Jackson, in the ninth grade. And during my whole high school years, I used to compete at Science Fair, which is always held here at Jackson State for the region. And because of that, I was exposed to some of the things that are going on at Jackson State. And I was exposed to some of the engineering teachers who talked me into choosing Jackson State.
I first moved from Colombia in 2004 and I went to Canada. And I was there for 2 years and then I came here to Mississippi. Of course it's different, everything is different, you know, all three places I've been, they're very different. But I like it, I like the environment, you know, people here are very nice. And yeah, I like Mississippi, it's cool.
There's a whole culture shock when I first came from Ethiopia. Language just takes some time to get to understand people. And food also takes time, but soon you get used to it.
I'm on part academic, part athletic scholarship, so I have to maintain certain GPA and I have to play tennis too. On one side, it's tough. You're gonna have less free time. You're gonna have to go to practice and at the same time do all your homework and study for tests and have good grades. But I wouldn't have it any other way. I like that pressure and being busy. I think if I would have too much free time, then I would end up doing nothing at all.
The scholarship I have is the engineering scholarship, and the School of Engineering is highly recruiting for engineering students since it's still a new engineering school and it is as accredited. And because of that, every year they recruit at the science fair and then the math fair. I can almost say that all the civil engineering students in my class, which is about 20 of us, have either partial or full engineering scholarship. It's free school, and you know, if you even have more grades, then they buy your books. And every summer, they help you find an internship. Makes you ready for an engineering career or a graduate school career, and you go to school for free.
Most of my family are engineers. My mom is a civil, my dad is a mechanical engineer, my grandfather. So I guess I've been pretty much made to go into engineering. My sister went to school in here in the States too with a tennis scholarship, and she went in Louisiana. So she's older than me and she told me like all, you know, her experiences in the South and all that. And when the opportunity came to go to Mississippi, she was like, you'll be fine, you know, it's Louisiana, like you'll be okay.
Begin with, I value education. And that is something anybody should have. Like, nobody can put the value of education in a student to begin with. So you value education. You get into a program and you have students in that class that you would relate with. Like, I have certain students I relate with, and you stay around those students. You always, you know, help each other, and when one feels down, somebody else is always up, and that always keeps you going. And also there's that competition, even though you are friends, my group of friends anyways, there's always competition, so you always try to outdo the other one, and in that way, competition makes it better. The other thing that is really convincing me to actually consider graduate school is the teachers, the professors here. Most of them are highly dedicated to what they do, and they love what they do. So when you are in a class with somebody who loves what he or she does, that really gets you excited. So I never thought I would want to go to graduate school and do research and all that stuff, but over the course of these past 3.5 years, I've done some research on campus, they found some research at other campuses, and they've showed me that, okay, there's more than what you know in this field. And the faculty is a big driving force.
It's small, there's not that many students, so you can get really close to your teachers. If you need help, they're very available for you. So that's a good thing. I know other bigger schools, if you need any help or you want to talk to your teachers, it's really hard to get in touch. You got huge classes, and I think in engineering sometimes you need, you know, for tougher classes you need small, and being able to interact more with your teacher than you do in a huge classroom.
I think Jackson State has, in a way, the best of like two different worlds, and it is an HBCU. But at the same time, it's becoming more diverse. Just like me, there are people from Colombia, you know, people from Mexico, Canada, everywhere. And it's, in a way, it's becoming a lot more diverse. So you get the HBCU experience as well as you get, you know, the other big school experience without having 40,000 students to push around with. I like the fact that it's a small school with big school opportunities. You can come to Jackson State and go to school, and you can really be whatever you want to be.
I've met people here from all over the world, from many different countries, and just being aware of all the different perspectives there are, I think that helps you. I love Jackson State. Jackson State has done so much for me, and I'm so grateful for that. It's been very welcoming to me, you know, giving me a scholarship, allowing me to play tennis, and the people I've met here, classmates, teachers, and they've been great. And wonderful.
Well, we can start. When I first got here, this building was not here. This is the engineering building, and it was not here. The plaza was not finished yet. The union was not there. You know, there are a couple of constructions going on that just got started. And in the past 3.5 years, this campus has grown like a lot. People, I always meet alumni that come and say, "Well, what part of campus are we on?" And if it goes the way it's going, I think that this school is gonna grow a lot, and the student body is gonna grow. I like the small student fact, but I guess, you know, when you grow, you just gotta grow all in all. And the campus, it's growing majorly, and there are more people coming every year. And the number of students has been growing every year. You can go wherever you want to go from here. It depends on how you take your opportunities. And you can compete in any field in what you do. It just depends on you, really. You have all the tools you need, and it depends on what you do with it. But Jackson State does the job by giving you the tools.